Just build good equipment and take care of your problems. It's that simple.
I won't say anything about Mike, Jerry, or myself that we did this or we did that, because without all of our loyal and dedicated employees, we wouldn't be where we are today. I would put this company's staff up against any company in the world in that respect. Hard-working, loyal, dedicated people, and they deserve the best.
Great people? You know, you hear people complain about employees. I don't. You're always going to have 5% that are a problem, but the other 95 are great.
We get along well and we do things together, and watching people grow within the business and being proud of all those people that helped us along the way in building and expanding Bandit.
I worked, I believe it was 16 years for Morbrick, which is owned by my uncle, which was a great guy, but really hard to work for. In that time, I spent 7 or 8 years working on the road, fixing the equipment, working with customers. That was great. I learned a lot about equipment. I was really proud of what all of us that worked in that department did. We could build one a day, which back then, that was a huge machine. Unbeknownst to me, he and a couple of engineers supposedly designed a new machine to take its place. And then he came in my office, oh, by the way, starting next week, you'll build my machine. I went home that night and said to Di,
I quit.
What are you going to do? I said, I'm going to build chippers. It's what I've been doing.
I wasn't totally surprised, but I was a bit shocked. You know, it was a lot of risk, but I knew that he was so frustrated that, you know, he couldn't continue doing what he was doing at Morbrick. You know, Mike's real conscientious, and his products are important to him, and my uncle is trying to change the design of a lot of our key machines there, trying to produce them without testing them, and Mike knew that he was going to have to look after that, and he didn't want all the hassle, so he had resigned.
I had a little office. In fact, it took me a week to get the rat droppings out of it, and that's no lie. And cleaned up in that office was a book of encyclopedias. And I knew I wanted to have it be the brush something. I opened up the B book and it opened right to a picture of a raccoon, and below it said Bandit. And I said, all right. I went on a 20,000 mile trip and signed up, I think, 3 dealers to handle our products. Sold it to the last dealer I signed up, and I knew I need help.
You have to quit your job and you have to come to work for me. And I said, yeah, right, I'm sure.
I said, I'll make you a deal.
What in the world would I know about manufacturing?
It'll only be part-time.
I need a personnel manager, and you are so good with people. That's what I need. Jerry Murray came on board too, about the same time I did.
I left in July. Okay, I probably started coming over sometime in mid to late August and started looking at everything. And then we decided, okay, yeah, we're gonna do something.
Dennis Tracy came on board too, and Dennis and Jerry really grew our sales department. That decision was made by Mike too, because he did not want to be in sales, and he knew in order for the company to grow, you definitely needed some good salespeople there. So Jerry and Dennis fit the bill beautifully in that respect.
Mostly, we concentrated on beef because chippers fall apart. And so I wanted to be able to go show people that would be selling them that we're gonna be heavy duty. And we'll take care of you. I learned over the years on the road, build a good product and stand behind it. Because you learn what customers go through. They earn their living with this stuff, and they're not happy when it doesn't work. I said, build a good machine, keep improving it, and if you screw up, take care of the customer. I have lived by that. I've taught the young guys out here, make it strong.
If they fail, a lot of people are left idle or a lot of equipment's left idle. Uptime is really a key, and downtime's the killer. It was so important in the designs that Mike came up with that the machines be strong and that they hold up and be reliable.
We've learned a lot of things over the years as far as how to do things right. We've done some things wrong. If stuff breaks, he says, throw more material at it. Help strengthen the machines up so they withstand everyday use and abuse. Make them easy to work on. You want the guys out in the field, if something happens, to be able to work on it right then and there. I see the future being very bright for Banda.
I think the future is very exciting.
Oh, it's unlimited.
I think the future is tremendous for Bandit. We've really positioned ourselves well in the market. We're one of the market share leaders in just about every product line.
Just look around us today, you know, we've got expansions going on. We've got additions going on. I can see us continuing to grow because we work as a team here at Bandit. It's not just one person that does anything and everything. It's teamwork. Not one person can do it all.
The direction we're going in now with selling the company to the employees. We feel very confident in the committee that we have.
The people we have in this committee have the resources and smarts to take it.
It's going to be a great opportunity for all of our employees. They'll all have a share in the business. A lot of incentive for them to continue to build on what we have already built and make this company grow even bigger and stronger.